Where is it? Yes. For example, it says, you stop me when I change from one section to the other, all right? I will read it again and you will say stop every time I start a new section, let's say. Drawing on Dweck's theory of motivation, the current study investigated the relationships between language learner implicit theories of writing intelligence, their writing motivation, and their orientation toward written corrected feedback. A questionnaire was developed based on previous studies.
Up to there.
Okay.
Stop.
You should have stopped, yes? So this is part of what?
The introduction,
yes. All of a sudden, I changed into a questionnaire was developed. If I'm talking about questionnaires, I'm talking about methods already, yes? So a questionnaire was developed based on previous studies and administered to 142 English second language writers at a large university, et cetera, et cetera. The questionnaire included, so we keep on talking about the questionnaire. The questionnaire included the items measuring learners' implicit theories of general writing intelligence, their orientation towards written corrected feedback, their writing motivation, and their background information. Multiple regression results showed that, stop. So I have this phrase, results show that, which is just transparent at all, yes? Multiple regression results show that. So we moved into the results section, that the incremental theory of writing intelligence, and then we have a definition of what incremental theory is, significantly and positively predicted, you see, mid-position of adverbs. Yes, instead of predicted positively and significantly, we have mid-position of adverbs. Predicted the student's feedback seeking orientation, whereas the entity theory of writing intelligence, and we have the definition, was a significant predictor of the feedback avoiding orientation. The following sentence, moreover, the incremental theory of writing intelligence, but not the entity theory of writing intelligence, was a statistically significant predictor of second language writing motivation. Writing motivation, in turn, was most strongly correlated with the participants' feedback seeking orientation, accounting for 41% of its variance. So all this has to do with results. Yes, we don't have any kind of discussion so far. We are just reporting what we found. So that would be move 4. And finally, we have only one sentence. Pedagogical implications and future research directions are discussed. So which is the main aim of that particular author by writing this kind of abstract? What was he or she or they interested in telling the audience? About how teaching can be improved?
Showing, sorry.
I don't know who's speaking. Ana Belén?
Yes, someone else was saying something. So it's okay.
I don't know who was because
I was saying that the author is interested in showing the readers that he or she found results.
Mm-hmm.
That's the main topic.
All right, like. More with had to do more with the core of the research design. Yes, what they did in the laboratory, how they analyzed all the answers and options the students marked and everything. But they didn't give that much importance to the pedagogical implications. Yes. So if you as a reader are interested in knowing how is this useful, you will need to go and read the whole paper. Yes. Because what the authors wanted to sell, let's say, is the kind of hard work they had or carried out when analyzing all the answers from the questionnaires. Yeah, so it has to do also with your stance as a writer, what you want to highlight on what you want to, hide somehow. But the important thing is that we have a little bit of every single part. If you don't know anything about the topic and you read the abstract, you know basically what the paper is going to be about. Okay? Good. So now I will stop sharing.